Amigos, continuamos con esta hermosa travesía. Ahora nos encontramos en la calle Allerton, 72 Allerton, y estamos de frente a este bello monumento dedicado a los antepasados. Debido a todo relacionado con los peregrinos, la llegada de ellos aquí, y el monumento veo que tiene muchos símbolos, mucho texto que habla un poco de esa etapa de los Estados Unidos, de los peregrinos, cuando llegaron aquí. El museo se llama National Monument to the Forefathers, o Monumentos a los Antepasados. Es un monumento muy importante y muy visitado por muchas personas. Voy a tratar de entrevistar a algunas personas de las que veo aquí para que nos digan por qué están aquí visitando este monumento y también por qué están visitando Plymouth. Me imagino que debe ser por la historia, igual que nosotros que queremos llevarle a conocer a ustedes. So, espero que disfruten todo esto. Para mí ha sido hasta ahora un viaje muy especial porque nos habla de cómo empezó esta gran nación de los Estados Unidos y llega muy al corazón, visto desde el punto de vista de una persona que tiene un punto de vista positivo de América. Por eso empezamos esta serie, porque en verdad queremos ver por nuestros propios ojos si en verdad la gente en verdad está tan dividida como los medios quieren ponerlo. Yo creo que no, yo creo que América está más unida de lo que aparenta en las noticias, y es como que hay una fuerza enemiga que quiere dividir este país, porque divididos podemos ser vencidos, unidos jamás. Así que, amigos, espero que disfruten de este bonito monumento. Amigos, nos encontramos aquí con una persona que ha accedido a darnos una entrevista de por qué está aquí y de dónde es. No conozco su nombre todavía, pero yo solo le pregunté si estaban de acuerdo. Can you tell us your name, sir?
Chris Thompson.
And where are you from?
Louisiana. Central Louisiana.
Central Louisiana. This is your first time coming to Plymouth?
Yes, sir.
And what made you, and I see your wife is here too, what made you to come to see Plymouth and especially the monument here?
We were at a pregnancy center banquet. It's a pro-life banquet back at home, and Kirk Cameron was speaking, and he spoke of the monument. And we had never really put a whole lot of thought into it or heard of it, really. Mm-hmm. And then when he gave the details of what it meant, how our founding fathers based everything in their society off of number one, God, and so on and so forth. So we decided to come see it. We had a trip planned, so we diverted to come over here.
Great, great. And based on that point, from what I heard from you, you know, granted, I didn't speak to you beforehand about what you just told me, but how do you feel about America's as an icon of hope in the world? Or for the American people, anything changed in the latest days?
I mean, as an American, there's a lot of turmoil going on, and if we could all sit back with a little, I think humility is something I brought up to a group of men the other day. If we had a little humility and reached across the aisle, we'd probably be pretty good. But as to directly answer your question, I'm proud to be American, and that America is a beacon of hope for everybody.
As an, you know, I'm a naturalized citizen. I came here when I was 14, and to me, it has been a very positive experience of America. I haven't experienced the darkest side that the media seem to portray lately. Like I was on the USS Nimitz from '92 to '96. Over 5,000 people from all over the world, actually.
Right.
And I never experienced anything of racism and things like that. And I felt like if in the 90s I didn't experience that as a Latino, and hardly spoke English back then, believe it or not, worse than now. Do you feel that right now is the media dividing us more, or the politician, or the combination of the two?
Absolutely both. The combination of the media and the politicians. They don't, they're not out there where the rest of us are at, the regular workers and whatnot. I'm a veterinarian, excuse me, by trade. and do a lot of farm work. So I work with a lot of Hispanic, South Americans, African Americans, and then just regular Caucasians, farmers and whatnot, black, white, or indifferent. And I think it's the biggest disparity in America is rural versus urban. Because in my world, in rural areas and whatnot, we all get along, we all help each other, and it doesn't matter cut, color, creed, or whatnot. And the media separates that. And then you've got this divide of the urban America, who is far stretched from, I mean, we could get on the food topic and everything else, mm-hmm. and we need all kinds. And that goes back to some humility to realize that there is another side to each and every story.
Okay, but how do you feel about me as a Latino embarking on this venture to go to red state, blue states, and asking people about this type of things, but it's mostly focused on nature and the beauty of America. But I also wanted to contribute to society, as mostly I feel that America is not as bad as it's being portrayed in media lately. So I want to experience for myself that part. Do you feel that I'll be okay going to Louisiana as a Latino?
Absolutely. Come by our house and take a ride with me during the day. Go to half a dozen farms and work on cows, horses, goats, sheep. Maybe go work on a dog or two. But I do think you would be fine, because by doing what you're doing, I think you can get the pulse of America. Because the worldview of the average person here in Plymouth or New York or wherever you're from, versus my worldview in rural Louisiana is completely different. And that's okay, but having that perspective that there are other views and the people there are perfectly happy and perfectly content. And I don't want to change how anybody here lives, as I would hope they don't want to change how I live.
Okay, great. Well, I may hold you to that. So if you guys don't see him, if you don't see him again in Louisiana sometime, maybe he didn't hold back his the end of his bargain, or I didn't go. So thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Louisiana, come on.
Thank you so much for the time.
Thank you.
Take care.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Have a good
Can you tell us your name and where you're coming from?
Sure. My name is Ralph. This is my wife, Sandy, and we're from Charlotte, North Carolina.
Okay, great. And what made you come to this monument and to, I assume you're going to the Mayflowers and the rest of the tour?
Yeah, well, we came here. We heard about the monument through the movie Monumental. By Kirk Cameron, and it was the foundation of our country, and we just would love to see our country come back to its original beliefs and its love for God. And so we've come here to pray and ask God to draw the hearts of the people in the U.S. to come back to Him.
Great, and I believe the last couple that I interviewed, They also came because of Kirk Cameron. So it must have been the same movie that they watched.
Yeah.
They didn't mention Monumental, but they just mentioned Kirk Cameron. But I think it must be the same thing. So how did you feel since you're praying for America? Are you worried about America?
Well, we're not worried. God is sovereign. He has a plan. And regardless, it'll happen. But we just, in our lifetime, we would love to see our country come back to God.
Do you feel that it is mostly the media or the politicians or both that are causing more division in America? Because do you believe that America is really that divided?
I think it is a lot the media and politics. It's easy to see what differences exist, but in fact we're all Americans, and we've lived in Asia, we've lived in Europe, worked throughout the Americas, and this is still the best country in the world. And so we pray for this country that it would be better, but we still believe this is the best place on the face of the earth. And we've seen other places firsthand, having been in 46 countries. We're proud to be Americans, and we love this country, and we pray for this country and everybody in it.
Okay, well, my point of view is that, I haven't traveled a lot within the U.S. to know more about the people, and that's why I want to start this new series, to get to speak to, with the people, and at the same time continue to do what I like to do, get with nature, landscape, a beautiful America I want to show everybody. But I also want to find out if it's true that we are so different, that we are divided, because my experience has been a very positive one in America in the last 36 years. So I want to know for myself, is the media just hyping everything up? Or should we really, is America still something worth fighting for? I believe it is. I came from a third world country. I think this has been the best thing that happened to me. And I think otherwise people would not be coming here in such a large number if America didn't represent change, positive change, or something good for the rest of the world. I think it's an icon of hope, but I want to keep an open mind and see what the people tell me from different areas in the country. Do you think as a Latino I'm going to have any issues going to red state, blue states, and asking people this type of questions?
I don't think so. I think when you engage people directly, people are people, and I think you'll find that there's a heart for inclusiveness. There's a heart for the fact that we're a nation of immigrants. And the premise of America, what it was based on, what you find here, is worth fighting for. And, there may be people that aren't aware of it, but at the end of the day, our encounters with people one-on-one have fundamentally been good.
Do you think that, to me, it's a little bit shocking to see some politicians treat other politicians because of different party as more of an enemy than foreign enemies. Do you feel that, or am I not right on that position?
That is where the spirit of division is amongst the politicians. Amongst the people, there's diversity, but there's unity. And I think there is that portrayal of division through them. And when I look at the U.S., I think of us as us, not as us and them, but as people who try to create division. That spirit is on them. I don't think it is on the whole U.S. or the people of the U.S.
So a lot of times the division comes also from not understanding the true position of the opposite side. And I think we just got to listen to each other more rather than listen to the media, what they're trying to portray about each other. So let's just pray to God that things do change for positive things. And let's hope it starts soon.
Yeah, we hope so.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
God bless.
God bless.
God bless you.